Hi, I'm Nikki and I work at the admissions office at MSM. And today I'll be answering your frequently asked questions. As you can see, I have quite a lot of them, so grab a drink, grab a snack, and let's get started. So the first set of questions are about the orientation phase. So the phase where students are still figuring out which university they want to go to, which program they want to apply for. I have some questions about that. So the first one, what is the difference between the Master of Arts in Management, so the MM program, and the Master in Business Administration, so our MBA program? So I think the biggest difference is related to the work experience. So our MM program is designed for freshly graduated students. So students who just finished their bachelor, maybe just finished their master program, and have 0 to 3 years of work experience. Our MBA program is targeted at professionals with at least 3 years of work experience. And you will also see this difference in the teaching method, because the teaching method of the MBA is different, because we want to try to incorporate those experiences from everyone into the teaching and linking the work experience to the actual theories that you learn. So that's why it's different. And also the MBA has more credits, more ECTS, and also has a specialization phase. So that's in short the difference between MM and MBA. MM is more for students to kickstart their career. If you are not sure which program suits you best, contact us, contact the recruiters, and they will help you figure out which program suits you best. So, next question. Am I eligible to one of these programs? This is a question we get a lot, and it's a bit difficult because we cannot answer it over email. In order to assess if you're actually eligible, you need to apply and upload all the documents that we need to review. So it's a bit difficult to give like a straight answer to this question. However, if you want to have an indication on if you should apply for the MM program or the MBA program, you can also do the free CV assessment on our website. There you upload your CV on the website, it goes to one of our recruiters and they will take a look at it and see if you're eligible for either MM or MBA. This is only an advice. They will not say like, okay, you're 100% eligible. It doesn't work like that. So they will give you an advice. Okay, I think MM suits you best, MBA program suits you best. And then they can help you with how to apply, if you have any problems that they can help you with. So they give you that guidance from figuring out which program you like to actually applying. So if you're interested in that, go to our website and do the CV assessment. So the next question, how do I apply and which documents do I need to apply? So if you're interested in one of our studies and you want to apply, you can go to our website and go to the page of the program that you're interested in. And on that webpage, it will have this box with apply online. And if you click it, you'll be redirected to our application portal. So there you will have to upload documents. So we need your degree and your transcript. Your degree has to be comparable to a bachelor degree or higher, and it has to be from a recognized institute. And both your degree and your transcript need to be certified. So they have to have the stamps and the signatures and all the official business. We also need your CV and your motivation letter. On our website, you can find guidelines for the motivation letter. So if you're a bit hesitant, like how do I have to start writing my motivation letter? What do I have to write about myself? Take a look at the guidelines for the motivation letter. It will give you a bit of a bit of an idea of what we wanna know about you, and that might make it a bit easier to write your motivation. So CV, motivation, passport scan and recommendations. If you apply for the MM program, you need one academic recommendation. And if you apply for the MBA program, you need two professional recommendations. And in some cases we need proof of English. So of course you can be exempted from the English language requirements, but not everyone can get an exception, unfortunately. Our website has an overview of all the English language test results that we accept, the minimum scores, and when we can give you an exception on the English language requirement. So, next question. Do I need a GMAT or a GRE result to apply? No. Good news. No, you do not need it to apply. Of course, if you have one that has a score of 600 or higher, amazing, great, submit it. But if you do not have it, then we offer the leveling courses. So to make sure that all our students have the same basic knowledge, we ask them to complete either the GMAT or the GRE with a score of 600 or higher, or the leveling courses. So if you do not have the GMAT, you will receive the leveling courses from us. This will make sure that everyone has the same basic knowledge, and these are courses that have to be completed before the start of the program. So, what is the application deadline? So, we have multiple programs, so we have multiple application deadlines. So, for MM and the full-time MBA, we have two different application deadlines. One is for the EU students and one is for the non-EU students. These application deadlines are different because for the non-EU students we have to apply for a student visa, and that takes a bit more time, so the deadline is a bit sooner than for the EU students. Then we also have the online MBA. The online MBA has two intakes each year, one in June and one in November. Then we have the executive MBA. That one sometimes has two intakes a year, sometimes three intakes a year, so make sure you check the website before you apply to see how many intakes there are. Please make sure to check the website and make sure that you have the correct deadlines written down. So, which scholarships can I apply for, and do you also offer full scholarships? Yes, we do offer a full scholarship. It's called the OKP scholarship, and it's a very competitive scholarship with very, very specific requirements. So I advise you, if you are interested in the OKP scholarship, go to our website and read about it first. There are specific rules about being eligible for it or not. There are specific documents that you need, specific steps that you have to follow, and of course a deadline. So if you are interested, please read that information on our website and make sure that you follow it very precisely. Because it's a competitive scholarship and it's not that easy to get it. So we also offer partial scholarships that you can apply for when you apply online for one of our programs. For example, we have the Dienst Development Fund. This is a fund based on your nationality. So based on your nationality, you will get a discount of the tuition fee. If you want to know for your nationality what a discount is, please go to our website and go to the scholarship section at the program that you're interested in. And there's a drop-down menu with all the nationalities. So just select your nationality and it will immediately give you your tuition fee with the Dienst Development Fund discount. So check our website if you want more information on that. We also offer other partial scholarships, like the Women Ambassadorship Scholarship, if you did work with empowering women, the Academic Excellence Scholarship, if you had excellent academic grades and everything. So check our website for more information, and if you want to see which scholarship you're eligible for, please contact us so we can take a look at it together. So another question is, can I pay the tuition fee in installments? In order to answer this question, I have to separate the programs in two groups. So the first group is the Master in Management and the full-time MBA. Both are full-time programs which require a student visa. In order for us to apply for your student visa, we need 50% of the tuition fee paid before a certain date. So of course, because we need a 50% tuition fee paid, it's not that easy to have multiple installments. So typically for the MM and the full-time MBA, there are three installments, one a month after you are admitted, one on the 1st of July and the one on the 1st of December. Because we have the rule of the 50% before the certain date, we cannot have, for example, monthly installments. That's unfortunately is not possible there. On the other hand, we have the online MBA and the executive MBA, which are both part-time programs. Because we do not need to apply for a student visa for those programs, we can accept payment plans, for example, monthly payments. So if you are interested in that, you have to send us a payment plan proposal so we can run it by our finance office. And if they confirm your payment plan, then you can, for example, pay in monthly installments or 4 times a year or whatever you like. So it is possible, but not for every program. So another very relevant question is, does the current COVID-19 situation have any effect on the admissions process? So yes, of course. As you can see, we are working from home right now. And of course, a lot of other offices and institutions and everything are closed. So we can imagine that it's difficult for you to obtain certified translations, IELTS results, TOEFL results, or whatever. So, of course, there is some kind of flexibility from our side. However, since this situation is developing so fast and changing so fast, I would recommend that you check our website. Our website has the most recent information about the COVID-19 measurements that we take, our flexibility during the admission process. So if you want to know more about that, please check our website and yeah, stay posted about all the new developments there. So let's go to the next step. So let's say that you know which program you want to do and you want to apply. What would that admission process, that application process, what would it look like? So first you would upload your documents into our online application portal. And then the admissions office will review your documents. So either myself or Steph, my colleague, will review all your documents and see if they are certified, if they meet the requirements, and if everything is okay. Let's say that we're satisfied with the documents that you provided. We will ask our colleague Adelina to schedule the admissions interview. And after the admissions interview, the admissions committee will decide if you are admitted or rejected. So as I already said, the admissions interview is a part of the admissions process. And we do get the question, do I have to prepare something for the admissions interview? No, you do not have to prepare anything. My colleague Adelina will send you an email to schedule the admissions interview. And the admissions interview will be with 2 staff members. That can be education officers, recruiters, academic coordinators, the director of education. And you will be paired with 2 staff members and they will ask you questions about you as a person, about why you chose MSM, why you want to do the program that you applied for. And on the other hand, of course, they are asking questions to you, but you can also ask questions to them. So if there are things that you are not sure about, if there are things that are not clear, if there's something that you still want to know, then that's the perfect opportunity for you to ask those questions to our staff members. So it's a bit of both. We want to know about you, but you also get the opportunity to know more about MSM. And of course, the goal of the interview process is to see if you are a good match with our program and if our program is a good match for you. So then, how long does the entire admissions process take? Because as you can see, it's quite a lot. It's applying online, reviewing the documents, scheduling an interview. Then the admissions committee have to decide if they want to admit you or reject you. The entire process takes about 3 weeks. Of course, this depends on if your application is complete. If you submit a fully complete application, then that's great, that's awesome. But sometimes people do not have all the documents available yet, or we have to wait for the recommendations to be submitted. So of course, then it can take a bit longer. Some people are available for the interview the next day. Other people are available for the interview in a week. Of course, those are all factors that can influence the duration of the admissions process. But in general, the admissions process takes about 3 weeks. So, you have been through the admissions process, you've been admitted, well done, congratulations. But what happens next? So first of all, you will receive an email from me or from staff saying, okay, well done, congratulations, you are admitted. With more information about, for example, your final tuition fee. Did you get any scholarships, yes or no? And what are the payment deadlines? So after you make your first payment, you will receive a link to the leveling courses. So as I explained earlier, if you do not have a GMAT result, you can do the leveling courses. And yeah, they will be sent to you after you made your first payment. And those leveling courses have to be completed before the program starts. And then around May, June, July, we will reach out to you, because then it's time to apply for your student visa. And we need more information from you, more documents, in order to be able to apply for your student visa. So that will be around June, July. So let's say you got your visa and you can travel to the Netherlands, then you get here. And then of course you need housing, you need student housing. One of the questions that we get a lot is, does MSM help me with finding student housing? We do not help you directly. We do not have a list of available rooms for rent that we just give you a list and say, well, let's go. We do have a list of housing agencies that you can reach out to. We have Facebook communities that are specifically targeted at rooms for rent, student housing. We also have information from our current students and our alumni about which housing agencies they had a good experience with, or if there are nice places to live, you know, which part of Maastricht is really nice to live, which part is maybe a bit far away from the city center. So we do not offer direct help, but we do have a lot of information available for you. Another question is, do you offer student services and career services? Yes, we do. We have a student service officer, Denise, who organizes multiple events like movie nights, pecha kucha. We have career services targeted at, for example, soft skill development, workshops. We have a mentorship program for the MBA. We have a corporate week. So yeah, we do organize a lot for our students, and yeah, it's always a lot of fun. So let's say that, unfortunately, due to unforeseen circumstances, you cannot join MSM. What are your options? So you have two options. You can either defer or you can get a refund. So first, defer. Your admission letter is always valid for 1 year, which means that if you apply in 2020, you can also use the 2020 admission letter to be admitted in 2021. However, it's only valid for one more year. So if you are admitted in 2020 and you cannot make it, you also cannot join 2021, then you have to reapply again in 2022 if you then still want to join. What is also a possibility is getting a refund. So if you are admitted and you already paid, then you can get a refund. Of course, that refund depends on when you drop out. So let's say that you drop out after we apply for your student visa, then of course you cannot get a refund for the student visa application fee, because we already used that fee to apply for your student visa. But if you drop out before we apply for your student visa, you can get a refund for the student visa application fee. So it's a bit tricky, and it depends on when you drop out. Our full refund and deferment policy is available on our website, so please check the website if you want more information about that and to have the most recent information available. Oh, our final question. What are my options when I finish the program? So a lot of our students ask us, okay, I'm almost done with the program. Can I stay in the Netherlands to find a job here? Yes, you can. You can apply for an orientation year where you get where your visa is extended for 1 year, so you can look for a job here in the Netherlands. You can also, of course, decide to go back. Maybe you want to go back to your family, or you have a job that you can go back to, or you want to go to another country. Of course, that's possible. But it's also possible to extend your visa with 1 year to look for a job here. So that was the final question that I had to answer. I hope that everything is clear, that I answered your questions that you had. If you have any further questions or any other questions, please reach out via social media, via email, admissions@msm.nl. And yeah, have a lovely day, and I hope to see you around at MSM.